Most IEDs are made from a few simple parts. A power source, like batteries. A main charge, like homemade explosives. A detonator to set off the main charge. And a switch, like a pressure plate or tripwire that closes the circuit and triggers the IED. On any given night, a single bomb maker can bury dozens of IEDs in the soft earth.
Husky's up front, trying to find the best path for us to get through.
The Husky methodically scans every inch of the road. Its four ground-penetrating radar panels detect anything unusual underground. Manning the controls is Sergeant Lopez.
Driving the Husky is amazing. A lot of people don't like it because you're in there by yourself and you get, you know, you go crazy and you end up talking to yourself. There's a lot of responsibility, a lot of pressure. You're the first man on that route. You're the first one to roll over that IED or bomb if there's one there. My guys are behind me, so I'm letting them know that it's clear.
As the convoy creeps forward, the team looks for any sign of insurgent activity.
Everyone in every vehicle is either doing what I'm doing, scanning my sector via this crow screen, or out their window, saw them a crack hand, and even the driver, they're both scanning their sector. They're just checking what's on the ground, what might be out there, any possible indications of enemy activity, IED emplacement, and things of that nature. So this entire convoy is doing the same thing.
At the front of the convoy, the Husky's radar detects something suspicious underground.
Just be safe, want to cut the buffalo up?
Yeah, go ahead and mark it and let the buffalo go up.
Roger.
You don't want to take any chances. Might as well get up there with the buffalo, take the extra time.
Blake risks his only buffalo to investigate. Now, it's up to Sergeant Bruce McCracken to interrogate the possible IED with the vehicle's 30-foot arm.
All right, see it? It's up there.
When we're interrogating an IED or we have a hit, I think everyone kind of puckers up a little bit.
Straight. All right. On the right, you'll see a red ink mark, and that's where the Husky got the hit.
At this distance, a big IED could take off the front of the buffalo, and McCracken's in the most vulnerable seat.
Sergeant McCracken, he's up in front of the buffalo, so whatever he's interrogating does dead. It might be detrimental to the people up in the front of the Vic.
And now, we're going to investigate.
There's definitely moments where things get real.